Hello, students. I'm Dr. Mike Lucas, and in behalf of Regent University College of Arts and Sciences and the General Education Program, I say welcome to you, not only to our fall semester that opens this coming Monday, full semester in Session A, but also specifically to the course that you're enrolled in with me, Genie 100, Making of the Christian Mind. I wanted to take a few moments with you just prior to our class opening to introduce myself, to welcome you, and to orient you just a bit on the upcoming course. Now remember, we don't start until this coming Monday, so there's no real concern as of today. I would invite you, if you have opportunity through the weekend, to go into our course area and begin familiarizing yourself. I'll get to that in just a moment. Just a little background about myself first, though. As I say, my name is Mike Lucas. I have a Doctor of Ministry that I finished at the Regent University School of Divinity, and also my Master's of Theology has come from that institution within Regent University as well. So I can heartily recommend the experience that you're going to have academically and spiritually here at Regent University, and particularly in the College of Arts and Sciences, the undergraduate program. I have been a preaching and pastoral minister for the last 42 years, 21 of which have been with the Bayside Church of Christ in Virginia Beach, Virginia, just a few miles from our main campus in Virginia Beach. I have ministered with churches in West Virginia, Ohio, and now presently Virginia. My wife and I reside in Chesapeake, Virginia, which is just south of the main campus by a few minutes and miles. And so we've enjoyed life and our experience in the Lord, as well as our experience in church ministry here in the mid-Atlantic along coastal Virginia in Hampton Roads. I know several of you are going to be coming in locally into our class from right here around the region, but many of you are coming from outside the area. So I want to welcome you to Virginia Beach and Regent University. By way of our course, let me just give this little high-level macro view of the nature and purpose of our time together over the next 8 weeks. Making of the Christian Mind is one of a few required courses in your undergraduate work here at Regent University. I'm hoping that you've already had good experiences in other required courses, because this particular course is foundational to those and works in tandem with those as well. Making of the Christian Mind is designed to help us explore the Christian worldview when it comes to important issues and topics like, who is God? What is a human being? And what is true, good, and beautiful? We're going to be looking at it certainly theologically, biblically. We'll spend time in the Scripture, both Old Testament and New Testament, in some readings and exploration of some big themes that are important in answering these questions. But we're also going to be approaching this topic and these issues and questions from a philosophical as well as a contemporary cultural perspective as well. God intends for His relationship to us and our participation through Christ with Him in His grand kingdom vision and work to be as practical as possible. And therefore, in real time, we're going to be looking at how Christianity has influenced the culture that we're in and the difference that we're called to make as we interpret the world in which we now live through the lenses of the Trinity's revelation of themselves in creation, general revelation, and in Scripture, special revelation. So there's a lot that we're going to be doing in the next 8 weeks that will include, as I've mentioned, readings from Scripture, Old Testament and New, the exploration of specific and some general major theological topics and themes, as well as how those connect with the world in which we live. We're going to be answering the question, so what? What does the Christian worldview, what does Christianity offer as an alternative to the world in interpreting who we are and what our purpose is for being in this world at this time. We're going to be interacting with readings materials that are provided for you. You can see those in the course content area. Each week has its own folder of course content marked weeks 1 through 8, along with their specific dates. Every week's academic work begins on Monday and ends on Sunday. There's going to be a variety of videos that you will watch and interact with. We will establish group dialogues. All of us are already assigned to a group with your fellow students, and certain themes and topics from what we're reading will be discussion prompts for each week as we progress. Naturally, there are going to be a few assignments that are of a writing nature, reflective assignments, short essays. I'll give you more details about that a bit later. Quizzes concerning our readings and how you're keeping up with and interpreting those, as well as some exams, 2 major exams throughout the course of the 8 weeks. I'll get to all the details about that once the course officially opens this coming Monday. Another vital component of what we'll be doing is working through some assessments as you are working as students currently to chart a path for a career and vocation once you finish your degree program here in the College of Arts and Sciences. So I'll be walking you through some steps of some assessment tools that are provided by the College of Arts and Sciences that are a required part of not only this course, but your graduation and completion of your degree ultimately. They're not just assignments, though. There really are helpful tools that we're putting in your toolbox to help you identify your gifts and skills, your passions, your interests, and to be able to combine those with the practical education with the degree program that you have pursued so that you're on a good track to market what God has blessed you with in the open market as a future employee, as a future person pursuing a vocation that you have charted for yourself or that God is revealing to you. I'll be talking to you about those, as I say, as we begin the course. For now, I encourage you to go in, look around in the course, familiarize yourself with where things are, find yourself in one of the 3 groups that are established. You'll find that, I think, fairly easily. Open and download the syllabus and read through that so that you know what's coming there. And in the meantime, I'm praying for all of us, certainly praying for you, and I'll be back to see you again on Monday. May God bless.